Sally Smith about the project, and she describes the horrifying conditions that the Rohingya Muslims are forced to live in.
They are not in an IDP camp or a refugee camp. This is really a modern-day concentration camp. They were put there behind 20-foot-high barbed wire fences and surrounded by armed guards. That man, he was incredibly special. He was caring for his wife, who was dying. He was caring for his children. He, like 140,000 other Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar, have been put into this camp in 2012, continue to be put into camps. It's very clear that they're being targeted based on their identity as Muslims in a something like 90% Buddhist country of Myanmar. There's just an irrational fear of them, and they continue to be persecuted and killed today.
And the lack of medical treatment for the Rohingya in this camp is very clear when you see this movie. You see the sick, you see the dying, you see a burial take place, and a daughter just wailing for the loss of her father. Were you taken aback by the level of suffering that's happening inside this camp?
Absolutely. I've traveled all over the world. I run an organization that works on genocide prevention, and this is some of the worst conditions I've ever seen. It was absolutely horrifying to see people dying when you have hospitals less than a couple of miles away. There's just absolutely no reason for it. And, you know, we always say that these things should never happen again, and yet we continue to let them happen.
Do you think VR storytelling has the power not only to generate more empathy and compassion and understanding, but to also lead to actual change, especially at a time when there's growing fear and suspicion of migrants?
I work on genocide prevention around the world. I also work on countering hate speech here in the United States. And I think there are great applications for virtual reality, helping people connect with people who aren't like them in situations unlike their life. If I can put you inside that headset and I can stick you right into that camp, you can see what I've seen. You can be moved in the way that you might be moved if you were there in person. I can't put everybody on a plane and take them to Myanmar, but I know that if I could and if they could see this in person, there's nothing they wouldn't do to help. It's absolutely horrifying. Virtual reality just helps you connect with the empathy you would have if you were able to see things firsthand. Studies have shown that virtual reality does cause an increase in both empathy and action, and I think you're only going to continue to see that with increased use of VR, but also increased access to virtual reality.
And that was Sally Smith, executive director of the Nexus Fund, talking to me earlier about the camps Rohingya Muslims are placed in Myanmar. The Myanmar government has repeatedly denied claims of human rights abuses against the Rohingya people.